fundamentally, women and men nowadays love beauty, and it's something that you can't live without. And especially for the Asian market in Japan that we know very well of, everybody, even in home, they tend to care for themselves, and that's something they wish for. For Shiseido reaching the market in the products, it's becoming very fragmented, and there's very different ways of reaching buying our products. Online is becoming very strong, especially there are dedicated online sites besides Shiseido that sell our products. I think for Shiseido, makeup was something that after the pandemic, it's growing more so. The majority of the world, makeup was one of the things that you didn't have to do if you're not leaving the house. But skincare was always there, so that was always very strong. Sustainability is very important for Shiseido. Even last year, through 31 brands and 740 products, we were able to amplify replaceable containers. And even we're aiming for next year, 100% replaceable plastic containers. Our consumers expect sustainability and ethicalness, and also the product itself, the substance, has to be very clear for all of our consumers. We're starting from the containers, but everywhere else as well, our science behind it. Our scientists, we have a huge science lab in Yokohama, so they're all in researching the sustainability of our products. AI, it's beyond important. I guess it's becoming a tool now, and I think we have to be very clever on how we use it. But for the creative department, it's a must. It's going to be human-centric whenever, even if there's AI human models. For Shiseido, it's about skincare and body and mind. So that part will always be human. Maybe the surrounding could be something different.